Guys, it seems like we finally have the answer that we've been waiting for. Gigio Donnarumma is staying at AC Milan, according to the breaking news from Di Marzio and Sky Italia, who are extremely reliable. They say that Donnarumma has agreed to renew with Milan. 6 million euros a year contract, 5 years total for the amount of years. We said that there was gonna be this meeting today. Apparently it happened and the details continue to flow. 100 million release clause if Milan do qualify for the Champions League, 50 million if they don't qualify for the Champions League. Donnarumma's brother also got into the action on this one. He gets a contract of 1 million euros a season.
Thank you!
Mike, real estate for us. Oh wait, sorry. The release clause is also active in Italy.
By the way. And before I say anything, didn't PSG offer them something?
Yes, I was gonna say that after.
Okay, so I'll just say, I just wanna say, this has been a real, like, episode, a real saga. At first we thought he was gonna renew, all crazy stuff was happening. He was getting hacked on Twitter. We were really convinced, you know, it's gonna happen. He got mad, not a good relationship with Milan. Mino Raiola not good with the sporting directors of Milan, and we thought he was gonna go to Real Madrid.
We've heard
now,
this before.
Yes, exactly. But now it looks like he's actually gonna stay. He's getting a huge amount of money for an 18-year-old goalkeeper, and
I'm happy you said that. Third highest paid player in Italy.
He's gonna be criticized so much if he doesn't step up.
Are you
now
happy?
I'm really happy. Of course, he's staying in the Serie A. It's gonna be a huge thing for everyone. It would have been horrible if he left the Serie A because he's so young and he has so much potential.
Speaking about that offer from PSG, mm-hmm. PSG apparently offered 13 to 14 million euros a season for Gigio Donnarumma. They also threw his brother in the mix because apparently they wanted to stay together. And on top of all that, they were gonna give him a villa and some cars and all this kind of stuff. I wanna know if that offer's still on the table. Michael and I will take that and join PSG. But yeah, so apparently rejecting double what he was gonna get, over more than double, but the thing that really scares me is the release clause. I mean, 50 million if they don't get to the Champions League, I don't think that's gonna happen. I think Milan are gonna get to the Champions League. But 100 million, I feel like the market is gonna inflate so much, and even 100 million is not even that crazy anymore, what we're talking about for some players. Mm-hmm. And I think that Donnarumma is a world-class keeper. I'm surprised that it was 100 million.
I know, we're discussing this a lot too. It was very weird, but I do feel like, they're not stupid. Mino's not stupid, Donnarumma's not stupid. There's gotta be something they're not telling us. And maybe he just wants to stay there one season. Maybe Donnarumma really wanted to leave, but he just wanted to bring happiness to the club that really brought him up. And he was like, maybe he'll stay one season. And then maybe they have a deal for another club, maybe Real Madrid, maybe PSG, to buy him after the release clause. Because it's not that much money.
It really
is. For a keeper that's 18 years old that has over 20 years left in his career.
I know. That's what I'm saying. I feel like the 100 million release clause kind of puts a damper on the situation of, like, what's the security on this?
That's
on
what
things.
I mean, exactly.
Like, right away, any team could activate it and Milan won't be able to negotiate at all. And I think that 100 million, yes, it's crazy amount, but also if the inflation rate is going nuts, 100 million we didn't even talk about last year and now we're talking about it as release clauses, you know? And Belotti has 100 million release clause. Like, Belotti's still not at the level where Donnarumma is, just to be honest. And I think that congratulations to Milan, congratulations to the Milan fans. I know it was such a hectic moment. No one knew what was going to happen. So much was said, and it's probably going to be retweeted over the years of what happened with Donnarumma. But in the end, he does stay with this building Milan side, and losing him would have been a huge part and breaking point of this Milan who did so good in the mercato. So I feel like Donnarumma was still that cherry on top of the table, which still isn't complete, by the
way. He still needs a signature, and I wouldn't even be surprised if another episode happens. But he's gonna be so much money. He's also bringing his brother, like you said, Antoni. He was actually out in Greece. He was playing in a small team there. So you can't get better than that now. It's just, Milan fan, do you guys forgive him now if he stays,
course,
which is gonna happen?
Course,
or you're still mad with all these shenanigans that went through?
It was all BS. Mino Raiola, hate him as much as you want. He is the best agent in football.
He's
maybe
super,
Jorge
super
Mendes.
Agent.
But honestly, He killed it. He literally killed it. He got more than what Milan were originally offered for salary. He got his brother in there. He got the release clause that he was begging for, that he was arguing with Milan over. He did everything. And he pulled all of us in a whirlpool. Everyone heard about this story. You didn't have to be a Milan fan. You didn't have to be a freaking Serie A fan.
You didn't have to be a soccer fan.
This is what he does. This is what Mino Raiola does. It worked out big time for him. He got a lot of hate, but I don't think he really cares because he's going to get huge money from this deal and then a future sale if it does happen. But guys, breaking news, we're gonna have a full video coming out after this one later on tonight, recapping the news from Milan 2 and the rest of the Serie A teams. Mm-hmm. So stay tuned for that. Put your thoughts in the comment section below on what you think about Donnarumma renewing with Milan, and we'll talk to you soon. Ciao ragazzi.
Ciao guys.